Good morning, all of you. So today we'll discuss about the problems on some heat generated, then force exerted by one plate of capacitor on the other plate, then different types of different shaped capacitor, means different shaped systems or structures or conducting things. Then what is the capacitance of them? Like already we have seen spherical capacitor, parallel plate. We'll bring cylindrical capacitor, then two wires, two spheres. These are the types of numericals we'll try to cover. So let me just focus on first the three numericals, very good numericals on the heat generated here. So it is something, I'm bringing the problem like this here. So try to read now. In the circuit shown, all capacitors are identical. Initially, the switch is open and only the capacitor A is charged. After the switch is closed, a steady state is established. Charge on the capacitor A becomes 5 microcoulombs. Initial charge on this capacitor is closest to. This was the question. So initially, where there's a charge only on the capacitor. That conservation of charge, still some of you are finding very difficult, so I'm picking up this numerical. At least try to notice few things here. The initial diagram. I'll start with the initial diagram. I'm grouping that particular thing. At least through this diagram, please put effort and try to understand. So let the initial charge be Q naught minus Q naught. Did they switch? All are having same capacitance. No, I'll close the switch. So finally, what should be the charge on capacitor A Q naught so that the final charge on A will be 5 microcoulomb. So
the polarity.
Anything you can assume?
No, the final one also.
Final one, you assume it. If you get negative charge, change direction, finish over. No, no second thought. Why you are wasting time in that?
No, sir, final one. In this, we can change. Like if we get Q not negative, we can change.
Final also. Final also, you assume it something. Look at this capacitor. What about this capacitor? What should I do with this? If they're shorted, no, I should replace with a wire. So this will be a shorted one. This capacitor will be shorted. With these two are a local. let it be like this. We have, so finally, what should be the charge? No, the thing is, this was switch open. Now that the switch which was there here, it is closed. So I'm going to proceed like this. The charges in the circuit, let it be Q1 minus Q1. And here, the charge will branch, no? Q2 minus Q2, Q3 minus Q3. They are in series, Q3 minus Q3. This I'm not sure. So I'll write it. This one. So these are the charges. Green color plates, red color plates, blue color plates, yellow color plates. Apply the conservation of charge everywhere. Write loop equation, solve, you'll get the answer. This very good problem, I just specifically picked up to explain that one. So this is the A, this is a plate capacitor. So we'll do one thing. So yeah. A, I'll write it, B. C, I cannot use, D, E. These are the symbols. So at A, you write conservation of charge principle. At B, at D, at T, then write loop equation, solve it. How many unknowns are there? Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Four equations, four unknown. We do get answer, but the conservation of charge at isolated junction must be applied properly. Hi, at B, okay, fine. This is a B, no? Okay, now I'll start with at A. What was earlier charge? What are A? A is here. This is A I'm taking. This is B. This is D and this is E. So at A, look at that one. So what was the charge? Minus Q naught and zero. Zero should be equal to minus Q1 plus Q4. So Q naught equal to Q1 plus Q4. Now at B, what was earlier charge? Plus Q naught plus zero plus zero. Q naught. You see that one, Q naught, green color plates. Huh? Still, if you're finding difficult, it's a green color plate. So I think I can.
Sir, it should be minus Q.
Plus, which one? Okay, fine, no.
Minus Q4, sir. Q0 equal, Q naught equal to Q1 minus
A.
This one, huh? Minus Q1. I think I missed the sign. Now at B, plus Q0, 0, 0. This should be equal to plus Q1, plus Q2, plus Q3. So our Q0 equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Similarly, at C, at D. And this is a shorted, no, this capacitor. So just replace with a wire itself. At D, what was earlier charge? Zero. Minus Q3 plus Q3. I think this will be no use. Just leave it here. Now at E. At E, earlier the charge was zero. Zero, or we'll write like this, zero plus zero plus zero equal to finally Q minus Q2 minus Q3 plus Q4, or Q2 plus so the equation two. This is of no use, just leave it. Equation. So we need one more. So write any loop equation. So Q1 by C minus Q2 by C minus Q4 by C equal to zero. If you want, you write one more here. These two are in series, same charge plus Q2 Q2 by C. I think when year one, very good relationship between Q3 and Q2 will get it. Look at this loop here. The traversing of loop minus Q3 by C minus Q3 by C plus Q2 by C. Solving this, Q2 is equal to I think slowly we can get all the things. No? What is the condition? What is given for us? Q1 is given how much? 5 microcoulomb. So this is what the Q1, no? What we assumed it. Given is what? I'll write it. Okay, no. So substitute first value of Q1 in where all Q0. So we should get the value of Q0 here. I think this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this will be sufficient. And more or Q1, we know it. 5 microcoulomb. In solving, we'll get the answer. 8 microcoulombs. So solve it later on. There's no problem with the data. Everything is fine. I checked it. This is like charged capacitor. This type of numerical not in advance. So why I picked up is like one charge capacitor. Usually we did very simple cases, no, like a series, parallel. Now a one charged capacitor can energize a group of charged capacitor or a network itself. So there the charge at isolated junction alone will help us here. So you should not do mistakes like this. So like here charge will flow. So Q1 equal to here, same charge, I'll put it. I think these are some mistakes what students will do. You must give priority for charge at isolated junction. It's a very good problem. Those who are still finding difficult, no, just do learn at least from this, how to distribute charges, everything. Why same charge here, they're in series. Why different charges, they're in parallel. Sir, why not same charge here? No, they're not series. These two are not series. These two are not series. So therefore, different charge here. I'll come to later on this question. We'll... we have to calculate the charge flown through the switch after it is closed and total heat generated in the circuit. Find total heat generated in the circuit after switch S is closed. Initially, there's no charge, so it's not given. Initially, how they are? Initially, they are in series, so same charge will flow here. So initially, no charge in capacitor, so same charge will flow. No initial charge. First, we'll get the initial charges in them. So how much of charge will be? plus Q naught, minus Q naught. They are in series, no? So directly, so instead of using any formula, so directly take help of this one. Q naught is equal to plus C1 minus Q naught by C1 minus Q naught by C2 minus C2 equals 0. E1 is 6, Q naught 2, Q naught 4 minus 2 equals 0. So this will be 4 Q naught 6 by 8. (clears throat) 32 by 6, 16 by 3 coulombs. Keep it here. So there's a one data. Now let's close the switch.
So that is plus E2, no, sir.
Which one?
First equation, plus E2.
Plus E2.
Yes. Loop equation. Plus E2. So 8, it will become 8, no? Then.
32 by 3.
64 by 6. How much? 32 by 3, yeah? Okay, thank you. Yeah, no. After this, I'll close the switch. The switch is closed. What will the charge in them? Let it be different. Q1 minus Q1, Q2 minus Q2. So what should be the Q1? Q1 should be equal to C1 E1. It's straight away from here. We'll find out the next part. Q1 equal to C1 into E1. C1 is 2 into E, so this will be 12 coulombs. Q2 equal to C2 into E2, this will be 4 coulombs. 2 into 4, 8. Okay, how to trace out the charge, the next part. So here I told you the bucket concept, here it is what you have to bring. Look at the plate. Positive plate of the capacitor C1. Q1 equal to the capacitor directly connected across cell, no? And this cell E1 is what? Voltage source. So therefore, the potential difference across that should be equal to that of the capacitor, that of the cell. Because how this capacitor is directly connected across the cell, no? So the potential drop across the capacitor will be that of the cell. Similarly here. The capacitor is connected directly across a cell. So the drop across that should be called applied EMF. Okay, now we got this one. So how to trace out? I look at the plate, positive plate of capacitor C1. If you want, you can give the name for the plates A, B. Let this be plate A.
Sir? Sir, why is charge not conserved at the junction, sir?
Why it must conserve? First of all, why it should conserve? Need not know. You just wait for explanation. So this is plus A at plate A. Very best problem. Just very core ideas again explained. So what was the initial charge of plate A? Q naught. Then let's assume that some charge pushed into it. Some charge is being pushed here. I'll assume like this, the charge. charges here. So Q naught, some positive charge plus QA entered, and it has become, Q naught, and it has become Q1. So do we know QA? Yes, we know Q naught and Q1, subtract that. So 32 by 3 plus QA, Q1 is 12. 36, 4 by 3. Similarly, we'll analyze for the plate B. Ahead, plate B. Look at this. What was the charge? Minus Q naught. Plus QB charge entered there. And it has become minus Q2. Q naught. Q2 is minus 8. Three jar 24, 24, 6 by 3, 2 coulombs.
8 by 3,
yeah. Plate C will show it here only. Now look at the plate C. What was the charge? Minus Q naught plus Q naught initially. Equal to. Finally. so some charge entered, no? I made some system. The moment I close with some charge entered, after entering charge, then they become minus Q1 plus Q2. Try to observe this. What was the charge? Minus Q naught plus Q naught. Some charge after closing, say some charge entered, then it made minus Q1 plus Q2. There's only possibility here, no? Here. So can you conserve charge of plate X and Y? No, should not, no? Because it is connected. So it is not an isolated junction. Are you getting no idea? I'm just picked up this problem. There's no, sir, what about the charge of plate A and B? Because again, this wire is there, no? Because of this wire. That's why I'm just focusing only on the plates here. So there's no any isolated junction better because of this wire is present. Goodbye to that particular idea in this particular specific problem. So plus QC should be equal to minus Q1 plus Q2. Anybody value QC?
Minus four.
Plus or minus?
Minus.
Okay, then. These are the values, is what I got it. Okay, now with this, what happened? So, this is the one method of tracing out the charges. I think really it's a very troublesome for students to identify isolated, not isolated. So, this is the one classic example of where no isolated junction is what we introduced here. How to get the heat generated. So we'll calculate initial energy of the system, UI, final potential energy of system, UF, then work done by the cells. So can we trace out how much of charge has flown through the cell E1? QA only. And what charge has flown through the cell B? QB only. Already we have values, no? With that, and here QB charge, you check it all, it will satisfy this equation. QB, QC negative, no? So it will, you have to change the action, leave it just here, QC put negative that one. So it may trouble you. Actually, the QC will flow in this direction here. The QC only will branch out. QC only will branch out here. The QC charge will branch out. Now let's come for the directly the heat generated. work done, initial energy of the circuit, work done by the cell E1, work done by the cell E2, UF plus H. This will be Q naught square by 2C1, Q naught square by 2C2 plus. What is the work done by the cell E1? It does positive work, the cell E1, because positive charge is leaving the positive terminal. Almost all multiple ideas are there in this question. Try to concentrate here. So what about work done by the cell E1? It does positive work, no? So you write it QA into E1. What about QB? Positive charge enters positive terminal. We got QB positive only. So positive charge entering positive terminal. So therefore, this should be negative. QB E2 equal to finally Q1 square by 2C1, Q2 square by 2C2 plus H. Solve it later on. This is the heat generated. Okay, fine. So tracing out charges. So how to trace out a charge in every branch? Who is going to help it? Not cell. It's a capacitor which is going to help. Any one plate of capacitor is going to help you.
4/3, sir.
What? Like?
It is 4/3.
4/3 joule.
Yes, sir.
Let them everyone calculate. Four by three, somebody is telling, one of your friend. Okay, cross verify afterwards.
Getting 932/27.
That's what, check calculation later on. We'll see. Okay, let's take the another circuit. Take the question. Find the heat generated in the circuit when the switch is moved from position A to position B. Okay, no problem. Find heat generated. In circuit when the switch is moved from position A to position B. The circuit a little bit you may get in, so I'll make it very simple. Again, that bend all. This will be much easier, no? So initially the switch is at position A. it is fully charged. Now it will be shifted to position B. What is the heat generated? So get the charges now. Here charge Q1 minus Q1. So these two are parallel, no? So they should have different charges. So this will be Q2 minus Q2. And call this is Q1 plus Q2. Or give name Q3. It'll be easy for in calculation purpose. The initial. So we'll first get the Q1, Q2, Q3 value. How these two are? So it is like a series parallel only, no? So if you want to write loop equations, three unknowns solving that, it's needed. Or directly take help of series parallel. Two coulomb, outside two farad, 2C and 4C. Okay, I think it's capacitance. I'll write farad, the unit. Look at this 2 farad and 4 farad, how they are. These two are parallel. Effective will become 6 farad. So what is the drop? You call this drop as VA. Or VX you call it. Or V12. Anything is left to you. So let me call V12. So what is V12? Potential divider formula. Applied EMF into capacitance of other capacitor. If you want, you okay, no need. This will be applied EMF capacitance of other capacitor by sum of capacitance. These two are in parallel, no? So therefore, this should be 2 plus 4 plus 2. So 2 plus 4, these two capacitors, they are in parallel. The effective how much will become 6. That 6 will be in series with this 2 farad capacitor. But this, so I'll if you want, I'll give name A, B, C. Capacitance A and B are in parallel and that effective is in series. So directly I wrote potential divider formula. Okay, I think I'll write it one equation. I'll write it. It'll be easy for you. This is VAB. So this is CAB plus CC. So they should be equal to VAB. So what should be the value of this? They should be equal to, this is 12 into 2 CAB. What is the value of CAB? CAB is parallel. They are series, no? Or parallel. This should be equal to 2 plus 4, 6. I'll write it here. So this will be 6 plus 2, 3 volt. Okay, 3 volt I'll get it. So once if you get this 3 volt, now can you get charges Q1, Q2? It'll be much easier, no? Q1 equal to C2 farad or CA into VAB. Any symbols you can use. No? 2 into 3, 6 coulombs. Similarly, what is Q2 is equal to CB into VAB. CB is how much? 4 into 3. This will be 12 coulombs. Keep it here. What about the charge Q3? Can we calculate the potential drop across capacitor VC? The drop across this. Should be equal to so what is value of VC? VC should be equal to E minus VAB. Value of E 12, VAB is how much? 3, 9 volt. Then what is the charge Q3? Q3 equal to capacitance CC should be into VC. So this is 2 into 9, 18 coulomb. Q1 keep these values, huh? Very important. Now you are going to bring the switch to the B. Make observation of the circuit.
Regenerated zero.
Not zero. Will not be zero. Switch is brought to position B. I'll shift the circuit down.
Here 144 joules.
I'll wait. I gave some random values. I just took the random values. Okay, these are both the circuit. So this was the same capacitor earlier. So here the capacitance didn't change, So there were 2 farad. This 4 farad, 2 farad. This was capacitor A. This was B. And this was C. Now look at this. Which one are in parallel now? B and C are in parallel and A will be in series. And because of the, look at the two types of circuit here now. I have to bring both the. Little bit. Okay, I'll show the both the diagrams. At least you try to see it. Oh, we have space here, no? Just give some time. I'll rearrange all the things. Two plus four. Yeah. So will you again resolve this? Will you go for resolving? That's what I'm asking question. Will again resolve this?
No, symmetry.
You just compare these two circuits. It's a very good problem. Is there an ADO? I picked up. Is there an ADO? No need to resolve. No. If you're. Yeah. Okay, no. Look at this. Any chart distribution, now you are going to make it. The same Q3, now you are going to bring it here. I'll give you some color. Q3 minus Q3. So that Q3, I'm going to bring it here. Positive, no? So this will be plus Q3. Then, what about the polarity of this? This will become now plus Q2 minus Q2. The whole problem is all about just making this observation, nothing big. Please do make observation. The below cell is there. Huh? I think, okay, fine now. Look at this now. So this is about the circuit. So I need not to do again, redo this circuit. The positive charge from here will come, will become plus Q3. The charge flow will be like this, plus Q3. So that will divide Q1 and Q2. So now look at this. These are 2 farad, 2 farad. And look at plus Q2 minus Q2. So what happened? The initial energy, that one. Initially, there was energy in the circuit. How much? UI. Finally, how much energy will be? UF. I think UI equal to UF, no? Straight away, I'm writing this conclusion. UI is equal to UF. No need to solve it. You can check it, look at the capacitance. A and C are of same capacitance. The charge on them will be different. But the sum of UA plus UC should be equal to UA plus UC. Only charge got interchanged. So therefore here, one very important thing, UI equal to UF. So each generated zero, the answer may not be. We'll trace out the charge flown through each branch. So I should take help of this particular thing only. So what shall I do here now? What was earlier charge of the plate Q1? You can pick up any one plate or look at this plate. What was charge minus Q2? Now how much of charge plus Q2? What charge might have entered here? Some QB charge might have entered. And it has become from minus Q2, it has become plus Q2. So can you say what about QB? Minus Q2 plus QB should be equal to plus Q2. So immediately we'll get the value of QB. Similarly, let's come for the plate C. What was the charge? Q3. Q3 is how much? 18 coulomb. And it has become how much? Q1. Q1, it has become 6 coulomb. So what do you expect charge here? Left or this one? So Q1 is 6. And Q3 is how much? Here, I'm asking you to look at this plate. 18, now it is 6. So charge is left. So straight away, no need to write equation. You can straight away write the values here. So Q2 is equal to 12 coulombs. How much of charge here? 24 coulombs of charge entered at plate at this particular point. Then what was earlier charge? Q3, 18. Now it has become 6. So how much of charge here? 12 coulombs of charge. So that 12 coulomb should come here. So let's come for the plate A. Minus Q1. Minus Q1 was the charge. Minus 6. So now it is minus 18. From minus 6, it has become minus 18. So 12 coulomb of charge left it. So 12 coulomb charge should come here. So it will be like this. Okay, we are able to trace it out here. What about charge flown through the battery? So after getting all this, what about plate, this particular plate here, the charge? So 12 coulomb, charge left means 12 coulomb should be like this. No, what to do the remaining part? Come for directly here. Q2 is equal to how much? Q2 is equal to 12 coulomb. I'll write it here. This is going to help us here. So can we trace out a charge here? What actually might have happened here? What was earlier charge? plus Q2. Now it has become minus Q2. So 24 coulomb charge should leave. There's no other way. See, what charge enters one plate, that much of charge should leave. In that 24, it'll go here. 12 will go here. The remaining 12 should come out here. The remaining 12 should come. So that 12 coulomb, now it is flowing through this. So what is the EMF of the cell? 12 volt. And that 12 coulomb will come like this. And this is open, no? So that charge will flow here. Now this is very important. 24 coulomb, the moment you move the switch from A to B, the switch was here, no? The switch is moved like this. The moment when you move the switch from A to B, then what happened? The charge, 24 coulomb, it was here. It gets fully charged. Then once the capacitor is fully charged, then I'm going to move the switch. The switch is moved immediately. Then what happened here? 24 coulomb will flow. Okay, go this. So through this 24 coulomb. That 24 coulomb, what should happen? The 24 coulomb, 12 coulomb will flow here. 12 coulomb will flow here. The remaining 12 will pass through it. So what about this cell? Supplies or absorbs? It supplies energy, no? So right, supplies. Why? Positive charge left. So what is the formula? Ui plus work done by the cell, Uf plus heat generated. What is Ui? Ui equal to Uf. Some value it will be U plus work done by the cell, 2L into 2L. Okay, this will be really very troublesome for students. You have to stick onto the basic conditions, nothing bigger. All these formulas of heat generated, you should be very particular about the plate. The plate of a capacitor is the best friend who is going to help you here.
Sir, Sir, the net capacitance of this second circuit also will become 3/2 only, no, sir?
Okay,
then the net charge flowing will become 18 coulombs, no, sir?
I don't know what logic you are applying here.
Sir, 4 farad and 2 farad are in parallel, no, sir? In the second one, sir?
I don't know. You are making very complex thinking. Nothing to do. There is some change is made in the circuit. Will you agree or not, first of all? Is there any change
yes,
in the circuit?
Yes,
finish
sir,
yeah. Over. So charge should change, finish over. Why to think very big? Am I right? Is there any change in the circuit? Yes, connections are changed, you know. So finish over. No need to bother any other mathematics. Just stick on to the basics. Is there any change in the circuit? Yes, finish over. So things will change. Okay, now let me introduce to the different shaped capacitors. Let's finish off this topic. Okay, different shaped capacitors. First, already we have come across the spherical capacitor. Can you remember that? Spherical capacitor. What is the capacitance of spherical capacitor? So there's a radius R. So what all, I'll give charge. And this is very important. There's a, what is iron sphere? You write it here, what it is. Iron sphere. I gave a charge to it. What the capacitance? We just called it as capacitance. We derived it, no? 4 pi epsilon R. Can you remember this? Whenever capacitance, no? You got adjusted yourself to what? Like, parallel plate capacitor, no? So whenever you are solving a problem, I think the parallel plate capacitor is such a important concept. What are the other types of capacitors? Everything what happened, if I want to solve any K, if I want to apply any conversion of charge, if I want to apply KVL, if I want to write equation, no? I need a circuit. So when I need a circuit means I'll assume things like parallel plate. Similarly, this is spherical capacitor. We know 4 pi epsilon naught r. But in parallel plate capacitor, the teacher trained you that there are two plates are there. Plus Q, minus Q. So you, when you say capacitor, where is the other plate? The other plate is at infinity. This, for your convenient, this I'll write positive plate. Negative plate is at infinity. Okay, got this one. So here, where is the negative plate? Negative plate is at infinity because what is a negative plate in our capacitor? It was earthed, no? So the earthed plate is what? The negative plate. Will I agree? The earthed plate was negative plate. And what is the potential of earthed plate? Should be zero. And what is the potential at infinity? Will be zero. So therefore, I can assume that the infinity is another plate. Are you getting now? This is something very important, some conclusion we are making it. So why you are making infinity as another plate, or what basis? Come for here. What is the potential of earthed plate? Should be zero. So negative plate, where it is? What is the potential of negative plate? Zero. Come for this conductor. What is the potential at infinity? Will be zero. So therefore, the infinity will become the negative plate. Got this? So there's a logical way. Why means, if you want to draw a circuit even with spherical capacitors, then circuit means you must come to the parallel plate. This is one analysis, or say like a, you can say some methodology we are bringing it here. So we'll extend this for now. The two capacitors, spherical capacitors, if one of them is earthed. So I'll move on to this. Okay, there's a capacitor, radius A. It's a concentric, I think I... We can't do anything, limit. Okay, this is about the plate. this one, let me earth it. So let this be A. This is iron sphere. This is a thin copper shell or thin iron shell. I want the capacitance of this. So capacitance of this means immediately what happened? We should go for like a some sort of the parallel plate capacitor we apply is a potential difference, then plus Q, minus Q. The similar ideas is what we should introduce here. So look at that. There's a capacitance between B and A, and also between B and infinity. So you better take superposition principle. Okay? B and A one. There's one capacitance. Sir, how do you can say that? So we'll do one thing. Like if I give charge to this, will there be any charge deposited? Yes, it will be. So the equivalent circuit will come like this. This is the negative terminal, no? Between B and A, this gap. Next again, from between B and infinity. B and infinity, this is, I'll put like this. This will be much easier for you. Again, where the infinity, what is the potential of infinity, will also be zero. Okay, got this. So now what is this capacitance CAB? This is CB infinity. How to calculate CAB? How to calculate CAB means I should give a charge to a system. So I'll give a charge here. So here plus Q minus Q. So you assume that potential difference across these two. This is the basic thing. So once you get this, how to calculate potential difference, it'll be easy for you. So this is A, this is B. Now, if I give a charge, anything that will be plus Q, minus Q, then let me, and let this be plus Q. I'll give a charge to plus Q, this one. So it'll induce a charge minus Q ion plus Q. Or you do one thing, if you're finding difficult, just connect a cell. Connect a cell to this. So what it does, the flow of charge, you have to trace it. This is very important. You are supposed to analyze everything through this method. So there'll be, what will happen? The positive charge will leave this. This positive charge will go and deposit here. Okay, clear this one. The positive charge will go and deposit. It will induce charge minus Q. What all the positive charge is there, that will come out like this. The charge must be conserved. Okay, let's do one thing. So we'll give the name for them. This was A, no? Looking at the diagram, find out potential AB. We'll come to the problem later on. This is the, separately I'm analyzing it. What is potential VA? Go back to the electrostatics, potential of shell A should be KQA minus KQ by B. Potential of shell B. KQB minus KQB. Potential difference VAB. What should be the potential difference VAB? I think this will become zero. So this will be KQ. KQ B minus A by AB. This is the potential difference between VAB. Okay, let's find out the capacitance CAB. So what is the basic formula? VAB equal to, are you seeing the capacitance definition? What capacitance definition says? What the definition of capacitance is? I think I'll bring it everything. I'll shift it to another page. That's it. We'll discuss things separately. It'll be easy for you. Come for this. So VAB, that one. So is it, are you seeing parallel plate? Are you seeing the idea of parallel plate, plus Q, minus Q? And this is cell. So this is what we say. No? So what is VAB from the formula? So substitute that formula from here. This should be equal to KQ B minus A, AB equal to Q by CAB. So what is CAB is equal to, no? AB by K into B minus. K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So therefore, this will be the formula. 4 pi epsilon naught AB by B minus A. So whenever two shells are there, no? Concentric shells. That one. So what is the capacitance between them? Just equal to this much here. There's a background. There's an initial. It's very important. this is everywhere. I'll be using this concept only. Between two consecutive shells, what is the capacitance given by this particular formula? Sir, I'll vary the applied EMF. Then I think you know capacitance depends on physical parameters, no? Physical parameters of the system, not on the applied EMF. Now, there's a basic core idea, which is thing that one. So let's come to the thing here now. So here, what I did, there's a capacitance between B and A. See, now you can do one thing. Sir, I'll change the polarity. Instead of connecting positive terminal to the sphere A, I'll connect positive terminal to the shell. Things are same still. Things are same, doesn't matter. So therefore, what is CAB? Shall I write from this formula? And what is B, that one? This should be like it's an isolated sphere. So there are two capacitors are there, no? So and how they are? We are calculating what? The capacitance between AB, that one, across these two terminals. So shall I say they are parallel? The effective capacitance. So the capacitance of the system will be CAB plus CB infinity. What is CAB? 4 pi epsilon naught AB by B minus A. What is this? Will be 4 pi epsilon naught B. Got the idea? Here condition B greater than A. So why you are writing plus? Because how they are parallel. No? So I'm measuring CAB. I'm measuring across CAB. This what? The capacitance we are measuring here. The capacitance from B surface of the B to infinity will come parallel to it. So therefore, the effective capacitance of system. Sir, where you are measuring here? I'm measuring between these two points, here and this earth. Or you are measuring here, the other capacitance will come in parallel. So when you earth inner sphere or shell, this is the condition. Okay, I think we have started with this. There's a background, this one. So there's a condition. Directly, I'm writing from the initial background. Okay, let me earth the outer one. Outer shell, I will earth it. Two concentric shells, let me take it. So this, the outer one is out there. Shell A and B. What is the capacitance of the system? Both are shells here, thin shells. Will there be any capacitance between A and B? Yes, it will be. There will be capacitance between A and B. Will there be any capacitance from B to infinity? No, this is earthed, no? So therefore, what is the total capacitance of system will be? Total capacitance of the system will be is equal to only CAB. What happened to CB infinity? It's shorted. So therefore, this should be 4 pi epsilon naught AB by B minus A.
Sir, A to infinity?
How A to infinity will come? How A to infinity will come? We are connecting a cell like this. Huh? That's why whenever you are having a big trouble, you must bring this cell concept. It's not there in book. Okay, now you see that. So put the charge like this. We'll go for the tracing out charge. Plus Q charge. This battery idea not there. That's why in the books you find very difficult to understand what is actually why he is writing. So students just they analyze, and the plus Q charge should leave from outer surface and should enter here. Now you see things clearly. From A to infinity, anything will come. There are only two plates are there, no? Plate A and plate B. As our previous problem also, you should do like that only. All of you got this? I'll just take you back here. So here also the same thing. You are connecting that one. So here what happened? If I connect a cell from B to A, one capacitor. B to infinity, under capacitor. Getting the method, sir, can you show cell here also? Yes, I can show it. What is there in that one? It's not that cell should be applied only for one specific diagram. Some of you are asking the cell idea. Put effort to understand the basic concept very clearly. If you can understand that core logic, no, it'll be very easy. Any number of shells, let them give, can manage here. So what about the shell, the battery? The battery, I'm going to bring it here, no. So this is the, means no connection there, it is. Send it like this. What about the charge? Plus Q charge, it will send. And that Q charge will go and deposit here. It will induce minus Q charge on this. And from here, the plus Q charge will leave. It come like this. So now there are two plates are there. What is one? Plate A, plate B, and plate infinity. And plate A and infinity are both are having same potential. So therefore, I'll connect them to a common point. So there are two capacitors are there, no? B to A and B to infinity. Getting this? Sir, here also there should be, I say like a B to infinity. And again, what happened? It is earthed here. So therefore, that the B to infinity will get shorted, no? So why don't you draw one circuit diagram like earlier what you drew there? So I'll do one thing. Let me bring the same, the things, that one. So this is the B is earthed, no? So let's do one thing. This is B. So CAB, I'm asking you, no? Sir, from B to infinity, B to infinity will be there and it'll be earthed. In fact, some of you are thinking like this, sir, why can't be like this? And again, it is being earthed, no? Okay, now look at this. It is as good as. What is CAB? Will be only this much, no? Capacitance of system will be. CB infinity will be there, they'll be shorted. So this effective will become again. This idea of cell, this equivalent circuit must be there with you. Huh? It's not there, something just formula you have to remember. So outer shell earthed, only one capacitor. Inner shell earthed, two capacitors in parallel. And potential difference VAB, if you know it, there's a generalized formula where I'll be using in everywhere in the thing. There's a generalized formula. Potential of A is zero, no? I'm showing symbol. It's there clearly. Potential of A is earthed. I'm showing it. This is a generalized formula. Capacitance is independent. See, capacitance is independent of the charge. Therefore, I just brought a generalized formula. This is what I shaded here. It's a generalized formula. Blue color, what you are seeing on the screen. Let me bring the three shells so it'll be a little bit easy for you. this is okay, three shells are there. Shell A is rotated. Okay, these are the radii. A, B, and C. We have to calculate the effective capacitance of the system. Between what? Between A and B. So this is A. Or say like X and Y are related. Three concentric thin conducting shells. Concentric shells A, B and C. As shown, find CXY. Find effective capacitance CBC or XY. Let me write terminal XY. So in the circuit also will be easier. Or CBC will write it. Later on I'll bring XY idea. Find a CBC or find capacitance between system find the capacitance of the system between B and C. So you should really search for how many capacitance are there. So for this, what is the best way of working out here? So connect directly cell across B and C. Then look at the flow of charge, induced charge, then search how many capacitors are there, then how those capacitors are connected. So shall I put like this? There'll be capacitance between B and A. Sorry, between B and C1, B and A, and also from C to infinity. And the infinity and the A are at same potential. Okay, got this. So there'll be altogether three capacitance are there, and how they are connected is what you have to draw the circuit diagram. So let's bring some sort of terminal. At least you can manage things very easily. There's a one terminal. There's a terminal. I'll call this is X. This is Y. From between X, Y, yes, there's a one capacitance. Between Y to infinity, there'll be one capacitance. Between X to A, there's one capacitance. Let's draw them all. So there's a point X. So there's a point one between X and Y. Directly I'll connect a cell between B and C. So there'll be one capacitance. So here it will go like this. This will be one capacitance. So this is what CBC you write it. Then from C to infinity. So what is a what is the y will be there at infinity, no? Or y is just a point. Y is a point here. The infinity will be there. That somewhere infinity will be here. So from y to infinity, one capacitor will come. And that infinity, I'll show it here. Okay, this is, you write C. This is a plate. BC. You write like this. Again, what happened? The point A. This is A and this is B. Sir, why you are bringing again B and A? Say between B and A, there'll be one capacitor. B and A. And A is at it. And from Y, from the C to infinity, there should be capacitor. So from C to infinity. Okay, got this, sir. How come A and infinity? What do you mean by infinity? Infinity means not something far away here. Infinity means potential zero in terms of circuit things. So what is the potential at infinity? Zero. Potential of shell is zero. I'll make them common. So we do have set of two capacitors. So what is CAB? You know CBA. Any formula? No need to derive anything. 4 pi epsilon naught AB by B minus A. What is CBC? 4 pi epsilon naught BC by C minus B. In fact, here the conditions are like this. No? Then what is the capacitance of C? Is a isolated, like isolated capacitor. So this will be CB infinity 4 pi epsilon naught C. So effective capacitance between system. This should be equal to how they are. These two are in parallel. These two are in series. These two are in series. The effective of that is in parallel here, no? So after this, I'll give further symbol. This I'll call C1, C2, and C3. So this should be C3. CBA, this is C1. CBC, this is C3. And this is C2. So let me write here now. So this should be equal to C3 plus C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. You see, this is okay. If you connect a cell, if you connect a cell here, the charge will flow like this, no? That's all. Only why that earthing? That earthing is only to define zero potential. That's all. I think already I shown this in resistor chapter. What is the earthing? Earthing is just only to define zero potential. The charge, what pen will come here? Plus Q, minus Q, plus Q, minus Q. Are you sure? Mm-hmm. Do calculation later on. This is again, you check it, the mains advance. We didn't have even single question till date. I'm not sure, like, will they show interest or not, but so small concepts are there that if you can apply it, then you can manage it. So try other configuration. Let me go for the next type of things. There are two spheres, are there? There are two spheres are there, the radius of them be A. There's an iron sphere, there's a copper sphere. The separation between them let it be equal to D. We have to calculate the capacitance of this system. I came from that concentric one. You see the center of spheres. The center of spheres are separated by distance D. We have to get the effective capacitance of the system. I'll go back to the basic definition. So I'll assume that I connected a cell. This is given, find the two conducting spheres A and B are separated by distance D. Find the capacitance of the system.
Capacitance is defined between two points, no sir. How can we tell the capacitance of the system?
Yes, you can. What is there? Because where I connected across A, B, no? So here you see that one. I said system means what here? Find the capacitance system between B and C. Finish over, no? Nothing wrong.
That B and C thing only I will ask you.
Yeah, from there you are connecting.
Two points should be mentioned.
Because across what points you are measuring? Say it's simple like resistor. When you say resistance means you are going to connect across two points, no? Of the not of only B and C of total system, because here other things also will come, no? Therefore, I should use word system here. This is again, again, go back to the basic logic. This is the, you are going to connect a cell. Then what you're going to do, you're going to, this will charge Q will come and deposit here. It will induce a charge, then all together. So what happened here, minus Q charge, so plus Q charge will flow here. I think everywhere the thinking should be like this. We should there's a background what we needed before entering into the problems. Because see, what is the, why we are thinking like this? Because we have only parallel plate capacitor idea. Therefore, everything what happened, I'm just trying to bring in terms of like similar to parallel plate capacitor. So somehow if I can get the potential difference, they're separated by a distance D. And D, I'll put it very much greater than A, very much greater. This is a given thing. So what is the potential of A? K cube by A. Potential of B? K cube by B. Is it like this? Shall we write? No. Even, say like when you connected a cell, they're interacting, no? So what is the potential of shell A? Of this iron sphere A? K cube A minus K cube by D. You have to look at this diagram. Without this diagram, no way you can get into the problem. What is the potential of point A? Potential point A. So what you are going to write, KQ by A, because of this charge, minus KQ by D. Similarly, the potential VB equal to minus KQ by B plus KQ by D. So let's go for capacitance. How you define charge by potential difference VAB. We'll calculate VAB first. VAB means VA minus VB. So KQA minus KQD so this will become KQA So what is the basic idea of capacitance? Capacitance should be equal to Q by VAB. So I'll substitute this Q, KQ by A, KQ by B. So this will be 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by A. This is the capacitance of the system. Two isolated spheres, two conducting spheres. So this is the idea. So don't come out of this particular thing. So everywhere our thinking should be of this kind. Because how you define capacitance? What is the method of capacitance? We define capacitance equal to charge on inner surface of positive plate by the capacitance. The same concept is what we are going to carry everywhere. Okay, let's similarly go for cylindrical capacitor. They are long here. They are long. So the radius of this, let it be A. The radius of this, let it be B. This iron rod, the thick iron cylinder. Iron cylinder, this is the thin copper cylindrical shell. I think you are able to thick iron solid cylinder. I'm putting this basic condition. Okay, now we have to find out the capacitance, long this is. We have to calculate the capacitance of them. See, now capacitance is not only parallel plate. Any arbitrary shaped things will have capacitance. This is something very dangerous. That's why we have seen some resistor infinite networks. Know why they are given so much of importance? Because of this. You take the dish cable or the internet cable, it will have two wires, one called as the base, other called as like the mesh type will be there, that one. So one will be phase, other will be neutral. Current will be flowing, but there'll be capacitance between them. That capacitance open will cause for us the noise, or it will cause the disturbance. So capacitance is not only parallel plate. Any one conductor or any two conducting surface of any arbitrary shape will have capacitance. This is a very generalized idea. So I'll describe the question. A long cylindrical rod is surrounded by a thin cylindrical shell. Find capacitance per unit length. As they are long, no, we'll go for unit length concept. How to bring the condition here, no? So I'll again, the method is like this. I'll connect a cell if I connect a cell. So in plane diagram, cross sectional view, I'm going to take the cross sectional view. So what is the cross sectional view? It will be this radius A, this radius B. I'll connect a cell like this. No. So what this cell will do, it will push a charge. It will push a charge plus Q, and it will induce a charge minus Q plus Q. That plus Q, what happened, will be pulled by this negative terminal. Okay, fine. This is, so now the capacitance between them. So this is that solid cylinder. And this is that shell. Where charge is present? Charge is present, you know. So what about the electric field? We'll go for the direction of electric field. So how the electric field will be directed? It will be directed radially. Show at few points. Throw the length. The E bar will be directed, and why it should be perpendicular? Because we know both are conductor, no? The electric field, what happened here, should orient and should terminate normal to that. So what is the expression for E bar? Where the charge is present? Charge is present on the surface, no? This is similar to like a wire. This is similar to like a wire. So what is the electric field due to wire? Charged wire E equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R, where R is the distance, you can say. This is electric field. So for further, what is lambda? Lambda is a charge per unit length. Charge per unit length. So, we'll do one thing, Q by L. What is the length? For our convenient, we are only taking some part of the system. Keep it here, no. So now, how you define capacitance of a system? So we know electric field vector. Can you calculate the potential difference? VAB should be equal to integral of EDR. Why EDR? Why integral? Because it's variable, no? Depends on distance, you know. So this should be from A to B. So VAB equal to, this will be lambda 2 pi epsilon naught R. I'll do one thing. I'll bring later on. You'll get confused here. Into DR. Solving this, lambda 2 pi epsilon naught. Potential difference. Okay, this will be law.
AB should be equal to minus of integral B to N.
Potential difference VAB, no? It will be like a VA. Yeah. It will be, sorry, this will become. Okay, fine, no? Negative sign will not come. Okay, log of B by A. So I got the potential difference. So after getting the potential difference, so what shall I do now? Capacitance of system, C equal to Q by VBA. So Q, what is VBA? Lambda by 2 pi F naught R log of B by A. But we don't have lambda, no? Lambda is charge per unit length we have to define. Q by L, 2 pi epsilon naught. Oh, this R is not there.
Sir, why did you remove the minus sign?
Here, yes, it should be A to B, no? And this will come VBA, we want VAB. Sorry, it should be no. Okay, fine. This is the,
yes,
so 2 pi epsilon naught L by log of B by capacitance per unit length, we have to define, because long cylinder, no, L will become infinite. So per unit length, we'll define it. Even two parallel wires also, yes, they can have. Like this, many systems are there, so you work out. Let me introduce force exerted by one plate, other plate. Very important, the last one. It's a very simple formula based. So there are two plates are there. So there's the capacitance. So there'll be a charge on it here, no? Q charge, this will be minus Q charge. And what is the force exerted by plate X on plate Y? Find the force exerted by one plate on the other plate, the thing. So this particular positive charge which is there will produce field. So again, give the name. I think we used to give the according to Gauss law.
The direction of forces towards each other.
Yeah. Wait. So this is the field, you know. So the field produced by this will be in this direction. The field produced by this will be in the direction. So recollect the Gauss law idea. So then, here, so this E4, now the charge present on surface phi, shall I say, will experience force due to this one. And what is the total field at point P? The total field at point P is due to sum of E4 plus E5. And we know this is sigma by 2 epsilon naught I cap. There's another background, what we know. So shall I say that charge present on surface phi will experience force due to E4. Charge present on surface phi will experience force due to charge on surface 4. So what is the field produced by surface 4? E4. So can we write what is E4 is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Don't write sigma by epsilon naught. These are what? Conducting plates. The background, again, go back to Gauss law. This is E4, no? So E4 plus E5 is what? The net field between the plates. So what is the force experienced by the charge on the surface phi? It should be equal to minus Q into E4 bar. No, come for this. Let's substitute all the things. Is equal to F5 bar. This should be minus Q. E4 is how much? Sigma by 2 epsilon naught I cap. Look at minus I cap. So how that force will be? Will be towards left because we got negative sign. So therefore, charge present on the here is going to experience a force in this direction. Similarly, the charge present on surface will experience force due to the charge minus Q. Either way. So we can also think in another way that No, can we also put it the charge on the surface? F4. So this should be equal to what is F4 bar? F4 bar should be equal to plus Q E5 bar. E5 bar should be equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught I cap. So what is the direction? It'll be towards right. So like that will happen. And look at these two here. F4 equal to magnitude equal. No? So nothing but the force exerted by one plate on other plate. I just brought 4, 5 so that surfaces needed. No? So altogether, if you take the two plates, this is a plate having a mass m. This is another plate having a mass m. Here, what happened? I'll fix it to the wall. Both are kept on the rough surface. I'm just bringing the overall very generalized idea. And they are given charges plus Q minus Q. Will they exert any force? Yes, they'll exert force. What is that? Electrostatic force on each other. So this electrostatic force which is acting, so I think either AFs or not, no? So one more thing left over. So this will be further Q sigma, what you can write, Q by A. Q square by 2 epsilon naught I can. Similarly this. It depends on area of cross section of plates. Q square by 2a epsilon naught. So what is the electrostatic force that is equal to? Accounted from just now we derived it. Q square by 2 epsilon naught. So then still the plate is at rest and this is a rough I'm saying. And I it's in equilibrium. So what is the other force that'll be balancing? The frictional force. So like this you'll be introduced to the various different types of numericals. So what should be the quotient of friction mu? So Fe is equal to F. So Q square by 2A epsilon naught mu n. Normal reaction, this will be mg. In advance, you are going to expect quotients of like this, something little bit, some small basic. What charge you should give so that, what is the maximum charge you can give to the plate so that the plate Y will not shift. You can bring it here, no? So Q is equal to 2A epsilon naught mu mg. If the charge given greater than this, then the plate, what happened, will shift here, will shift towards left. There's attractive force. What is this? See, I'm directly bringing to the one application, attractive force between the plates it is. Now this particular force, what happen, is you treat it just like any other force in mechanics. Can it balance friction? Yes. Can it balance spring force? Yes. Can it balance weight? Yes. It will do all things. Now you can bring all the mechanics now between the plates. You can just introduce the mechanics here. So not only this. So here I'll suspend here. Okay, block. So here I'll give a charge plus Q minus Q. Let A be the area of cross section of plates. This is a string. And what should be the mass of the block for equilibrium of system? This is one plate, this is another plate. What should be the mass of block? There should be substance. तो ये व्हाट आर द फोर्सेस दैट विल बी एक्टिंग टेंशन mg ये टेंशन दिस विल बी टेंशन एंड ऑन दिस साइड इट विल बी इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स सो विल बैलेंस नो द टी माइनस mg सिस्टम इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम So T minus mg equal to 0. Fe minus T equal to 0. So therefore Fe equal to mg. What is Fe? Q square by 2a epsilon naught mg. So what should be mass suspended? So the value of m should be equal to Q square by 2a. Okay, fine. So these are some applications. Now the force acting on the plate. Now this plate, I'll connect to a spring. I'll keep it on inclined plane. I'll bring the conditions of friction. Now you can enjoy problems related to this. Mixed problems. This is very important for advance. Till now, what we discussed is all about some only capacitor confined. So now here, what happened? You can get the mixed concepts. Application problems will come. I can fill up a gas between the capacitor. I'll introduce thermodynamics. You explore now what will be that one. So just force exerted by one plate, other plate. Q square by 2 epsilon naught. Rest all everything, let water application come, let it be. So between the plates, I fill up gas, it'll become thermodynamics. If I fill up water, fluid mechanics, here I suspend a block, some mechanics, laws of motion. If I keep them on rough surface or inclined plane, friction will come. Then I can apply force, torque also I can bring it. I can do also inch one plate. No, here I'll apply force. Electrostatic force will not act at one point, will act at every point. So rotation mechanics ideas. So like this, no, it will become unlimited. So tomorrow we'll explore few more problems on this and other conditions. Any doubt, anybody, you can clarify. The spring problems, tomorrow I'll discuss that one.
The charges are different between two things. Then what will be the force exerted, sir?
In that case also, again, calculate the electric field. Calculate the electric field. So you can proceed like this. I'll stop the recording first.